compensate more, help me more. And then he went very quiet.
What went through my mind the whole time was just pretending to be dead, lie completely still, and when you get a gap, oh, just get up.
I cannot tell you how frustrating and how pathetic and small I felt standing on that side, that you cannot help him. And he's laying there, and there's three huge lions on top of your child. Two lions that was on his legs started fighting over him. They raised themselves, fighting with each other. That's when I grabbed his fence again, and I went totally mad. I screamed so much. The one that was on him, he lifted himself, and he lifted those claws out of Dane. And as he looked at me, Dane got up.
Somehow I got up when the exact same time when he was off me. I don't know how or why, but a stick lay next to me and I picked it up. I turned my back and started moving towards the fence.
And he came to me and he was standing right in front of me like this.
The lion turned around and came towards me. I shouted, no, no, repeatedly.
Hit him, Dane, hit him. He was with me now, but I could still not do anything for him. I was trying to hold on to him with a fence so that he could at least feel that I'm there, that I'm holding on to him.
As I shouted no, I would wave the stick at him and try to hit him in the face.
That they sort of kept the stick distance from Dane. And we walked to the top of the gate.
The lion could have taken me out any time. With one jump, I would have been gone.
And then Solo came.
One lion, his name is Solo. It's a beautiful lion, but he was huge.
He was in the corner on the other side, and as Dane reached the gate, Solo started walking towards us. Then the guy came, and they had a bunch of keys.
The lion's coming. I can hear the keys are here, but will there be enough time to get me out of this?
Solo came closer and closer and closer, and he dropped his head.
I knew this thing was going to kill me.
The first key they put in the lock opened. And I grabbed him at the collar and I ripped him. I think he flew out of there.
It was kind of a feeling of relief knowing that it's over now. I'm not going to get hurt anymore. It felt comforting to have humans around you. The whole thing was, it was a miracle. I don't know if it's because of the shock or adrenaline, I couldn't see any color at all. It was all black and white. And then everything just came back to normal. Seeing that happen to you was quite weird.
It's probably the adrenaline or whatever, but this child is walking.
I knew it was bad, but I thought it was a couple of stitches bad.
And as I looked to the front, I just saw this blood.
I had an army green shirt on, and I remember looking down at my chest and just seeing the red becoming bigger and bigger and bigger.
I knew that something major was wrong here, but I wasn't going to look and I wasn't going to ask him. The only thing I wanted to do was get to the hospital as quick as possible.
It looked kind of like a piece of meat hanging out of my calf. It was not real.
There wasn't a time for ambulance. There wasn't time for a helicopter.
Got worried because my mom and Janine were both so shocked and both of them crying.
We phoned the hospital and told them my child was attacked by a lion and I'm on my way there. While we were driving, he said, Ma, how far is it still? Because it's starting to burn now.
I felt it started burning over most of my body because almost everywhere I got had cuts and lacerations.
When we got there, they were already waiting for him.
everybody busy and doing putting drips and pipes and stuff.
The trolley passed me, gone. All of a sudden, it was this quietness. Nobody running, nobody around me, just this, just me. I knew Dane was injured very badly. Dane is my son. Parents don't bury their children. I cannot tell you what the time span was. It felt like forever. He wasn't supposed to die. They operated for about 5 hours. And then they told me that they nearly lost him. The surgeon came to me and he said, we'll have to do some transplant of skin because he had two big, huge gaps where the line bit him. Because of the muscles being so shredded, they had to cut 3 centimeters away. Then he said, because of that, Dane will probably never do sport again. That was one of the saddest things of this whole event. This accident for my child.
Waking up in ICU, I'm lying there the whole day, not moving. I'm not used to surgeries and needles and hospitals. And I remember thinking about the rugby. I asked her mom, what's gonna happen to my rugby? And my mom was crying.
I didn't know what to say to him.
I think that was about the first time that I thought that I would never be able to walk again. It was shattering, wasn't fun at all.